Right, let's head this direction. There we go. Right. No, I didn't want to kill the Wookiee. I wanted to get this guy. What's up, guys? John here from the Killabits, and yes, today we are playing something called Loot Rascals. Now, I'd heard about this game. I knew, at least from kind of the footage and images I'd seen, that this was kind of a little weird looking. It was this kind of hex-based tactics game using cards you collect from your enemies as a way of attacking and defending. But that's about it. I didn't know what to expect, really. And what I got is something really quite endearing. I mean, I've been playing this now for the last hour or so, and it's got a very quirky sense of humour. The tactics in it are quite deep. But, I mean, to explain the story, I'm probably best handing over to our holographic companion, I suppose, is the best way to actually describe it, to actually explain what's going on with the story. So, take it away, Mr. Teapot Head.
Wake up. Gonnae, wake up! Alright, we're nearly there, so I'm just going to talk you through the mission again, okay? Right, you're on your way to the site of a new outer space holiday camp, where the medical substance, liquid anything, has already been transported in a big baddie unit, which is a nickname, it's got a technical name. The big baddie should have by now prepared the planet's surface, poured in the liquid anything and initiated the 3D rendering process. However, we've lost contact. The most likely scenario is that flying space debris is snapped off the Big Baddie's aerial, in which case you should load the appropriate chip into your leg-mounted chip reader and use your helmet to render a replacement part. Before returning home, you should inspect the camp in case there's anything else we need to repair or replace. And remember, ensure that an area is clear before rendering in case you accidentally hit someone in the face, which can kill. This concludes the mission. Sorry, nearly put you back to hypersleep there. Oh, here's the planet coming into view now, look. So I'll guide the spaceship down to the surface and you just kill. I don't know what's just happened, but I do know that moon's not supposed to be there. And the bad news is, I've lost control of the ship. Oh, there's the big baddie, but his head's been stolen. Right, we're definitely gonna kill. Oh, hello, look at this bunch of rascals. Okay, well, the new mission is, let's escape.
So yes, we've crashed on this rogue moon and we have to escape. So as I said, I've been playing this a bit. Now it is procedural, it is all roguelike, it is using digital cards as your attack and defend. We can go back and I can show you that there's an element of kind of not so much online play, but kind of score attack type things. So we have leaderboards, which there are some people. I'm currently 32. I am playing a review build, so not a lot of people playing this. Somebody escaped. Wow. So I think I've got to area 2 or 3. No, area 2. There we go. So I haven't got that far. Settings. Fairly basic settings. We can select our character. I'm currently playing as the girl, but we can also play as this guy, but I'm going to go with her. What else was there? Graphics, fairly basic settings, tilt shift. This is coming out on both PC and PS4, so we can do PlayStation button prompts, but obviously I'm on PC. I'm actually using keyboard because I find it slightly easier for the targeting when you get special abilities. Language, clear save. So we'll just go in and I will explain as we go. We can do daily challenges, we can do practice games and tutorial, or we can play an actual seeded game, because as I said, this is procedural, but it's easy to actually show you in-game what's going on. So first of all, let's enter the dome, and we can see our little companion again.
Right.
So we can decompile unwanted cards for tokens, and we use the tokens to heal ourselves up. We've got the chef here who kind of gives us a mission during the thing. So Iris the Wellnut stole my special spectral destabilizer. Return it to 2 extra card slots. Okay. And we've got some kind of... Nope, I wanted to press E, not that. So how the combat works is we have to potentially attack whilst enemies are defending, otherwise we're going to get hit. But it's easier to show you rather than anything else. And we've got our default pack at the moment. This guy is just playing with finger puppets, so yeah. Let's leave and let's see how it's all playing out. So in the top right hand corner you can obviously see the minimap, and then next to it is actually the turn counter. It's saying in 247 turns there's going to be some weird aliens approach. But above that is the actual kind of day-night cycle, and every move it advances the day on. So as you can see, next move we'll go into nighttime, and now look above the enemy's heads. They're currently in defense mode. When we go into night mode, they're in attack mode. So this is where the kind of the tactics come in. Knowing who to attack and when to attack is kind of a must. Because, I mean, if you look in the top left, you can see our life is 5 out of 5. We've only got 3 attack and 3 defense and no tokens at the moment. And as I said, we get our attack and defense from these cards. So we can swap them in and out. At the moment, we've just got a basic set. So 3 defense cards and 3 attack cards. Now, as you'd imagine with any card-based game, they all have pickup kind of... Let's see if we can corner him with one move to go. Yeah, we should be able to attack. There we go. And now we can loot the corpse. Now, if we bring up our HUD thing, right, now this is where another element of the tactics come in. So if we put this here, as you can see, any card below it will get +2. Well, in that case, that's probably best to put on one of these. But it also has a negative quirk. Other putters, like this one behind it, would get a 0 cost. So I reckon we'll put this there and just swap it out, because if we have that on, it negates the actual advantage of it. So there we go. So we're getting an extra 2 defense, and we've got 4 attack now from that. So, I mean, we could actually do that, in fact, and get more attack to defense. But I think that that's a healthy balance to go on with initially. And we've got a bit of time yet before it turns. Right, and now we can chase after this guy. Now, the mice-type enemies have a tendency to run away. So we can kind of force them out. Now, we've got like a big ogre-type guy. He will come for us, and as you can see, he's going to hit a bit harder than the mice. So our best bet is to actually attack when he's in defense mode. So if we retreat a little, try and wind down the clock, and now we know next turn he's going to change his attack pattern. So if we both go into the center one there, oh no, he didn't jump, but now we can get him. We can go for the mouse as well. Oh, and we can loot that. What we got? More loot. Now the yeti thing is probably going to jump and attack us, so if I retreat one. Now, if we go down, there we go. So we can loot all these, and we can actually load up. Oh, right, so what have we got? Well, we don't want to put the putter back in. Cards left and right get +1. In that case, that's an easy one to do. Extra defense, because that's a 2 cost one. And blast bib. Right, and we've actually got attack. Card to the right gets +1. So in that case, we'll do that. And... oh, we could actually go all attack. So if we do that and that. So now, that's getting the bonus from that one above and that one. We're getting... yeah, so we're +12 attack. Natural fact... I'm trying to think what the best way of doing this is. Let's do that, that, that. Still 12 and 8. Yeah, I think this is probably the best setup. We've got more attack and less defense, but yeah, that, I'm happy with that. And now we have to try and find an exit. Now, the rat stack is... probably, we can probably take them with 12 attack, and the turn is about to change, so yes, there we go. And what have we got off them? Odd slot plus one. So, yeah, in a number five slot, that will get the bonus. So, we've got full attack and full cut. So, now we've only got five slots left, so we're going to have to be wary of that. If we start looting too many cards, oh! Ventragoon has got 11 attack, and it is in a he is in an attack phase, so I think we'll make a strategic exit. The bolus girl is gonna change soon. Saying that, he's gonna change to a defense mode as well, so let's go this way, and we get a special card now. So if we look in this, this is a special ability which we can actually add to a card, which will give us a heal ability. So why don't we put it on a defensive one? We'll put it on the plus two boot. Now if you look down here in the bottom right hand corner, we've got these are our defense abilities. Well, these are our abilities, and at the moment we've got a heal one. Obviously, we could heal ourselves if we had any damage, but we're all right at the moment. But there's also stuff like a flame attack, a shock attack, and things like that. So I think they're the only ones I've actually come across so far. But let's see. No. Okay, these guys are dancing around. We don't have to attack everyone. Our goal is to find the exit to the next stage, essentially. So what have we got here? Card to the right plus two. Other insect... what is that? Other insect boots. Minus. Well, I mean, that's giving plus one to either side. I think we hold on to that there and not actually use it. I think we go down. Yeah, that's probably a good idea. Get you. And I reckon go down and to the right, maybe. Right, now we need to get this mouse off the button because he's actually using this machine to summon robots. So we know that he runs away. And now... there we go. He's off the button. We killed him in a defense mode. She's got three more turns before she changes. Yeah, I'm going to just kill some time. Right, we know everyone's going to change now, so let's go for, going for the attack. Next one. So you can actually line up attacks, and as I said, it can get quite strategic. Now, the horse bros... I don't think I'm going to get him in time. He may come straight for me. Let's have a look. Yeah. That's all right. Ooh, special card. Now, these are bonus cards that only appear once on a level. So what's this? This is... spend 6 tokens to detonate a huge bomb. Well, we haven't got any tokens at the moment. The way we get tokens is we actually destroy our cards. So I'm going to destroy this basic card to show you how you do it. It's pressing R. That gives us one token. I'm going to hold on to these for the time being. As I said, we are looking for the exit. Yeah, we'll take out the ogre. This guy fires stuff off. So we really don't want to go into the spot he's targeting. So let's evade. Right. He's going to go into attack mode next time, so I think we go for the ogre instead. Let's get the ogre. And we've still got 148 turns before the bugs arrive. Ah! Now this is my only bugbear with it, is the keyboard controls are a little annoying. Okay, now we can't go into that square. He's really cornered us. Okay. Okay, we're going to have to take him out. And he's about to change anyway. No, I didn't mean to do that. I meant to go up. Damn it. Let's just take him out. Right. Now, what we could do is actually go back to our base. And what I will do, I'll use the power-up. So let's warp to the dome. That takes 25 turns. And we've got 98 left to actually find the exit, which we may be able to do. So, right. Now, to use the healing booth, we need two tokens. So, I will burn this. I'll burn this boot. And now we have two tokens, and we can go up to here and heal up. So, we did a fair amount. So we really need to go this way, because as we can tell, oh, we could actually go up there. That may be a way. So I reckon, I do reckon we've got to go down. So let's come out of the map mode. I mean, we could have actually used our heal. I forgot about that. Right. We'll avoid getting into a fight. Oh no, we're probably getting into a fight. Okay, now we can definitely get into a fight with this one. And we should be able to easily defeat. Right. Okay, well, that one just changed over. As you see, if they're in a defensive mode, they will defend. But if they're in attack mode, they attack first. It does feel like I'm moving in slow motion. I don't know if this is a weird bug with the game. So as I say, oh, a scuzzy witch. Now, I know she drops the ability to actually shock enemies. So yeah, we definitely want to take her on. So if we loot her card, as I say, we get this shock ability, like the heal one. And I'm going to put it on a really high attack, something like that. Now we have a shock ability as well, which we can actually shock over kind of rocks and things like that, but it is still within a range. And we might as well actually shock that, because it's weak to it and at least it gives us an advantage. So let's shock it. Come on. It is on that square. Okay. Oh no, I healed it. I thought I had the shocker. Okay, well, we'll loot that. Never mind. The heal will charge up eventually. What have we got? It's another boot. In column 2, we'll get plus 1. In that case, we'll go more defensive now. Okay, right. Okay, we're at distinct disadvantage at the moment. What's the... That is... Card below gets plus one. Only one of... Well, it is the only one. So we might as well just swap that out for a neutral. Oh no, it gets a negative for being the only one. Okay, in that case, but we definitely don't want it. Okay, well, they're both going to change, so let's just go down. Let's get that one. Let's get the bolus girl. And yeah, let's zap you. We really don't want to take on that rat stack. Though he may actually corner us, yes. Oh no. But what did we get out of it? Ooh. Now this is, again, is a special card. So let's see what we got. So that's a... even slot gets plus one. Well, let's put that... yeah, we'll go for... actually, this is a flippable one. So if we do that, we can actually turn it into a defensive one. But we do want the attack at the moment. So I'm going to swap that out for that. So we've got 14 attack, 13 defense. Yeah, I can live with that. Oh, and I was going to show you what this ability does. This does a burst, combined all defensive cards equipped. Now, I'm quite happy with our defensive cards, because what it will do, it will actually get rid of the special abilities for them. So, you know, like the plus one and all that kind of thing. But we're running out of space, so we may have to convert some of these cards. So actually, we'll burn these cards. And we've only got 35 turns left. Now, he's very strong. Let's hope... oh, no. Well... right, he's going to change next time, but it may not be... oh, right, okay. And that's the special card the chef wanted, but we've only got 30 turns. So I don't think it's going to be a good use of our time to actually go back. So let's... loot that. Kill him as well. So yeah, that was the special spectral card. So, right. Let's head this direction. Let's... there we go. Right. Now, I didn't want to kill the Wookiee. I wanted to get this guy. Right. What was that? That was a boot. Cards above, below gets plus one. But in that case, I'm going to put that there. And let's see. We've got to find the exit sometime soon. Because in 9 turns, bugs are going to start arriving. Okay, well, we'll take you out. What have you got? You have got... card to the right gets plus 3. Ooh. In that case, that is going there. And we're going to burn that, because they're fairly neutral cards. At least we've got 2 slots left. Oh, yeah, we'll go for you. I reckon we can take you. Now, this is one thing. So if we die... The enemy that kills us will take one of our cards. Now, that card will show up on another enemy, like that guy who had a name, in somebody else's game. So this is another part of the kind of online element. So the card can be used to belong to this guy. We can send it back or we can keep it. Well, it's just a very neutral card, so we'll send it back. We'll be nice to that person. And we're still looking for the exit. Oh, that's going to turn. Let's see if we can put force her out of the way. Yeah. Oh, no. It turned. What's that? That is... yeah, we'll decompile that. We don't want that card. We could really do with a heal station. Oh, so this is a night wizard. So what I'm going to do is going to zap them. And let's take what they've got. What do they have? Top row plus one. Well, our top row is all our attacks, so I'm going to ignore that for now. We're in a day cycle, so probably a good time. Ah! Now this is the rocket, so it means we're getting close. But that person is about to attack the 9. Okay, let's... run away from Lick Boy. There's the exit. Let's warp to the next area. So it took a bit longer than I thought, but we've made it to the next area. And there's Barry, right at the end. So Barry is at level 5. And let's continue. So, now I'm presuming the chef will want something different now for this one, yeah. Vogue the Gruesome stole my oven sleeves. Return it to reveal map card. So, that's something we need to keep an eye out for. Now, we could get the extra health. I think we'll get the extra health. And have we got any cards we can actually burn that we don't really want? Well, no point really holding on to that now. And as I said, I'm fairly happy with these. Actually, if we put that there and that there, we get the plus one for that, and that's still in the column 5. So yeah, we can get rid of another level 1 card. And if we get another dustbin lid that's quite strong, we could put it there and get the bonus for that. So I'm just going to hold on for that for now, unless we get a lot of cards in this next level. But let's find out. What have we got going on here? So it's another wizard type thing. Yep, we'll zap them. And oh, and that's the enemy we know we've got to attack. But they're in an attack phase at the moment, and I don't really know what their patterns are like. So let's... Okay, and he'll probably start turning in a minute. There we go. And we... No, okay, it was a different shark person. Now, these are bombs. I wonder if we get our zap ability up. We could actually zap that. Possibly? I don't know. It doesn't seem to want to zap. So I don't think so. Let's just run. As I say, the running seems to be awfully slow. Ah! I didn't know that was a thing. Okay. The ice is sliding. Right, okay, well, let's... And there's a bomb there, okay. Can we definitely not zap it? There we go. That's what I wanted to avoid. We'll zap the wizard. Webjack? Ooh, that's quite a tough enemy. Well, we'll attack that person. I have no idea what this station does. Abilities charged. Ah, so all of our abilities are charged. So we can heal ourselves, which we'll do. And we'll zap that person. Can we get across this thing? Yeah. Right. Let's slide across. Plunk. They're in a current defense mode, so yeah. They're quite a tough enemy. 30. I mean, we've only got a 19 attack. I don't really want to take them on. Right. This is where we die, probably. Now, if I loot, they're all going to jump on me. I think I'd take a strategic... There we go. We're fighting that one. Let's take the heavier hitter. Go on then. Abilities available. Can we chain zap? Let's see. Nope, we're dead. So, now you see, the enemy will take one of our special cards, and everything else is destroyed, and we die. And this is what happens when we die.
of your little friends? Barry's been teaching me all about this fascinating liquid he brought with him. You see, my influence over your dimension is limited, so I need representatives on the ground. I don't quite have the hang of it yet, but I'm getting close. In the meantime, we'd really appreciate it if you could keep the numbers down up there. We can't have those idiots passing Barry. Oh, and don't worry about dying. It's just a simple matter of reshuffling time. Now, back you go. Barry has so much to teach me. Your planet sounds lovely, Barry. You must show me how to get there.
Right, well, I think you were a dead body for most of that, so I'll give you the upshot. There's a thing below, or somewhere, and it's going to keep bringing us back to life as long as we kill the aliens around here. But what I'm thinking is, we find the big baddie head and fly it home ourselves, without that thing below, obviously. So let's get looking.
So, death is definitely a part of the game, but it's not the end of the game. Again, it's the roguelike thing of death is a learning experience. We're back to kind of all our neutral cards again, as you can see here. So, we just need to start from the beginning again, and we'll start looting stuff, start taking these guys on. We've got a defensive one. Card to the right gets plus one, card above minus. So, in that case, we'll do that. More defense, more attack. And let's just keep going. So, as I said, this is Loot Rascals. Ooh. Comes out on the 7th of March on PC and PS4. As I said, I'm using keyboard controls, but it does work reasonably well with a gamepad. Even slot gets plus one. Well, there we go. Lots of defense at the moment. And yeah, I think it's going to be about $15. Being beaten up by a Wookiee. Kill the ogre. My only concern at the moment is, as I say, the keyboard controls. It feels a bit slow. And I'm only getting like 36 frames per second, so it's... ooh. Lots of you guys, middle of the day, but that's a special card. Do we go? We'll go into the fort. Go on then. We'll take you all on. Go on. We're getting attacked during the hardest hitting phase. This is probably not a good idea, but what the hell. So yeah, as I said, this is Loot Rascals out on the 7th. If you're interested, as always, I will leave a link in the description below so you can check it out for yourself. And block, hit, block, hit. We're not doing too badly. There we go. Another point down. Another point down. Let's grab this. What's the special card do? Special card is hostile hollows become nice. Nice hollows become hostile. Well, I've not had any holograms actually turn up. I think you probably get them in later phases. Or yeah, you have to have a special spawn for that. But yeah, you get the idea. It's all about looting. So this is Loot Rascals. As I said, if you're interested, I will leave a link in the description. And if you enjoyed this video, as always, you can hit that like button and maybe get in touch with us in the comments below or on any of the social medias over at The Killabits. All right. Until next time, guys. Bye.